This interactive simulation models a continuous stirred tank reactor that's running at steady state for an exothermic reaction. So it has cooling to maintain the temperature. And then at some point, the cooling fails. And so indicates here we're running at steady state. The cooling fails, and therefore the temperature starts increasing. And the dashed line shows the behavior if we do nothing, if we make no changes once the temperature increases. This just results from solving the unsteady state material and energy balances for the CSTR. And then the blue line shows the behavior if after some time period the operator realizes there's a problem, temperature's increasing, and increases the flow rate significantly in this case to try and compensate, and the temperature increases almost as much, reaches a slightly lower high temperature. And so what the simulation does is look at what happens as we change the delay time between when the cooling fails and when we make an adjustment, and then what happens if we use different values of the new flow rate. And here we're showing temperature versus time in the simulation. We can also look at concentration versus time. So let's look at the interactive simulation, observe the behavior. So here is the interactive simulation, and we can see first we're looking at the case where we didn't change the flow rate. And so as we increase the flow rate, notice that it still gets to almost the maximum temperature until we really increase the flow rate pretty significantly. And so let's look at that a little more detail. Flow rate is 7.5 for doing this after at a time of 8 minutes. Reaches almost the same maximum temperature if we didn't make any change in the flow rate. And now, if I instead increase it to 8, we completely quench the reaction. So very sensitive to the flow rate, and even though our intuition might not be to increase the flow rate and provide more reactant, we're providing more cooling, and that ends up being the dominant behavior as long as we provide enough of it. Now, if we look at the effect of the time at which we make this decision, so if we wait longer, so now let's say 9 minutes, then we have to go to a much higher flow rate. And if we wait a lot longer, again, we keep increasing the flow rate, but we're able to compensate. Of course, if we wait when it's already at the maximum temperature, it's not accomplishing our goal of preventing the temperature overshoot. Well, let's also look at the concentration versus time behavior. So the system's at steady state, concentration of reactant, CA, the concentration of product. Cooling fails, then reaction's faster, so reactant concentration decreases. We increase the flow rate, and we start to see an effect. And now we've increased the flow rate enough, now we quench the reaction, we're not making any product, and we have our on reactant A leaving the reactor. And again, if we increase the time where we make that decision, we get some interesting behavior in the plots. As we increase the time, then we have to go to much higher flow rates. And at this time, we can't get to a high enough flow rate. So if we go back and look at the temperature, we're reaching that maximum temperature. So we can't wait too long or we're unable to compensate. But at shorter times, then we can compensate, change the flow rate, and quench the reaction, prevent the reactor runaway.